Hi, I'm Paul Kaiser for GoodLearning.com. Let's talk about alpha channels and how you can use them. For this tutorial, we're going to use Photoshop, but any decent image editing program will let you work with alpha channels. Alpha channels are also commonly called masks. Personally, I feel there's a difference between an alpha channel and a mask, but I'll clear that up later. The image we see here is totally opaque. That is, there's no transparency. Something totally transparent would be like a window. You can see through it. An alpha channel lets us indicate which areas of an image ought to be transparent. Let's go to the Channels palette. We see here the red, green, and blue channels, which actually make up our image. And then we have this, what Photoshop's calling our Layer 1 mask, which is our alpha channel. When we apply this alpha channel to our image, every pixel in the mask that is black will be completely transparent. Every pixel in the mask that is white will be completely opaque. You can't see through it at all. In an alpha channel, there are all these in-betweens between black and white, different levels of gray. The darker the gray, the more transparent that pixel area will be. The closer it is to white, the more opaque it will be. In my opinion, the difference between an alpha channel and a mask is that a mask has either black or white. There are no soft in-betweens. Let's show our image again. Back to layers. Now, again, here is our image with no transparency. If I tell it to enable the layer mask, which is basically turning on our alpha channel, you can see now, I can see right through the image to the background. That's what an alpha channel does. It lets us see through the image to whatever is behind it. If we then save this image in a compatible file format, we can place the image on top of another background or image and see it coming through right here where our layer mask has opened up some transparency. Alpha channels can also be used to adjust the intensity of your image editing operations. Let's say I wanted to blur this tomato photo. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's just do some pixels. Well, I've blurred the entire thing, but what I really want to do is highlight this nice juicy tomato. So I don't want to apply the same amount of blurring to the entire image. What I'd rather do is blur it not so much here, but blur it more as I work toward the edges. In Photoshop, I can go into Quick Mask Mode, which essentially lets me use painting tools to operate directly on the mask. I'm not building the image when I'm in Quick Mask Mode. I'm actually building the alpha channel itself. Let's do that and show you the results. I'm going to use the Gradient Painting Tool, and I'm going to use it in Radial Gradient Mode. I'm going to start at the middle of our tomato, work out to the side. Now what you see here, this red that you saw just show up, this is showing me the pixels on my alpha channel. If I want to see that better, what I can do is hide the red, green, and blue channels. Now I'm just seeing the alpha channel. So you can see here, this is a result of my radial blur. I'm going to turn those back on. There are a number of ways of using this alpha channel as I'm doing my editing. One way is to go from mask, quick mask mode back into standard mode, which is what you see the selection, the marching ants. Now, you're not going to see the nice gradation because there's not really a way to indicate that with these marching ants, but indeed the gradation is there. It looks just like that alpha channel black and white that we saw there a moment ago. So now, let's see, I'm selected on the tomato, so I'm going to actually inverse. So I have this area selected. If I apply blur now, let's go to Gaussian Blur Tool. I'm going to increase. What you can see as I increase it, is I'm blurring more out here than I am in here. Let's say OK and have a look again at why that is. That's because, I'm going to go back to my quick mask and show it. That's because my alpha channel, my mask here, is letting more of the effect through here and less of the effect through right here. So it did less blurring here and more blurring out there. When you're done working with an alpha channel, you probably want to save the results. So you need to pick a file format that supports and saves the alpha channel itself. If you're in Photoshop or Paint.net, different programs like that, and you save the native file format, it's probably going to save your alpha channel because it's saving all that information. That's usually the largest file format you can use. But you could also use the TIFF file format, TGA, which is actually Targa file format, or PNG, Portable Network Graphic. Those are three file formats that will store an alpha channel. Now, a GIF file can technically store what I was calling an image mask, but it only has one color, so there's no slight gradation like what we used here on the tomato. So that's what I'm referring to as a mask rather than alpha channel, because it's either on or off. Well, I hope that this little tutorial has cleared up a little bit what an alpha channel is, how you can work with them, and how they can be beneficial both in compositing images so you can see through the background, and also in applying editing effects at different intensities across your image.